Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Hello, dear family of God. We bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you. Beloved of the Lord, blessed of God, family of God, household of faith. This is your time to arise and shine. This is your time to be full of God's joy, full of God's glory, full of God's anointing. This is your opportunity right now to arise and shine. Amen. We are hearing so much recently in the last few days, last few weeks, no problem. We hear of fear and of panic. We hear of many believers really panicking, fearing in this corona situation. Let me tell you, your God has not given you a spirit of fear. Your God has given you a spirit of love and power and sound mind. Very good brain, sound mind, self-discipline. So first of all, I want to challenge you, refuse to fear. Resist fear. The devil is a liar. The devil is a deceiver. The devil will try to come with fear, but the devil is already defeated. Amen. This corona situation, we are going from lockdown to lockdown. Actually, the Holy Spirit told me, see this lockdown as a reset. See it as a reset. We know economically, we know in many, many different areas that a lockdown can be very difficult, very dangerous for people. People crowded together, just the stress and strain of being crowded together can be very difficult. So if you are in a lockdown situation, you need fresh air, you need sunlight. Be happy, there is less pollution, you can breathe the air much better even if you live in a city. Be next to a window, put enough sun on your skin. I wrote some articles, read these articles, there are so many ideas. You will have to plant your own food, food will become very expensive, food might not even become available easily. So you plant your own food, there are so many things, there are for example herbs, there are medicines that kill virus, powerful medicines, antivirus medicines. For example, rosemary, you know rosemary? You can get the seeds, you can get the small plants, you can grow them in your own home, you can cut a water bottle in half, turn it around into the cup, make a small hole, put some rope through that or some cotton cloth through that, fill the lower part with water, fill the upper part with soil, duck, put it like that, let it drink, let it draw water from below, plant the seeds. You can use rosemary, you can use cilantro, you can use thyme, you can use basil. One more, I will write it on the video. One more is there that you can use. They are very, very powerful anti-viral drugs. Of course, you can use the kashayam. It was sold out, I don't know, I hope it is easy to get. Kashayam is one thing that you need to use as a prophylaxis. Fresh air, sunlight, the joy of the Lord. There are many, many things I want you to do right now. While you are at home, while you are safe, while you are healthy, you need to protect your health. You need to protect your mental health, your emotional health. You need to do some exercise inside the house. You need to keep your immune system going. You know why nowadays we have more hospitalizations? You know why more people come into a serious condition? Because of the lockdown. When you cannot get fresh air, when you cannot get especially sunlight, which helps the body to produce vitamin D3, D vitamins, your immune system gets lower. Then you use so many of the sanitizers. Actually, the immune system should be active. The immune system should be exposed to some little bit of dirt. When you play in the dirt, when you work with soil, your immune system gets activated. Your immune system grows stronger. Sitting only in a very sterile environment will make your immune system very weak. So you just have contact. You play, touch soil, breathe normal air, have some normal life, sunlight, air, touching soil, having relationships. Don't allow that mental torture of being only alone, sitting at home in a dark place and being afraid. Don't allow it. That will lower your immunity. When you have touched anything, okay, then sanitize your hands, but normally it's not such a dangerous thing. Actually, it's a virus that can easily be overcome by your own immune system if you don't spoil your immune system. Look into many articles I have written, videos I have done. Please study that. Check. If you work on your immunity, And you know the number one thing for working on the immunity, the joy of the Lord is your strength. You need to work on the joy of the Lord. You should never allow the devil to steal your joy. You should not allow the devil to hit you with that panic. When the panic comes, when the fear comes, you can see in my brain book, all the negative, the whole body goes into shock mode, into negative mode. The immune system is one of the first things. The cardiovascular system, the digestive system, and the immune system. These are the three systems that get attacked when you have toxic emotions, when you allow fear. Your immunity goes down when you allow the fear and the panic. Do not allow it. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Amen. Your God has made you well able to overcome whatever virus, whatever bacteria comes. Okay? I already told you, take C vitamin as much as you can. After some dose, the stomach would feel irritated by the C vitamin. So that level you have to stop. But D vitamin, you can take 2,000 units. If you really have symptoms already, even for a few days, you can take higher than that. Zinc, normally 80 to 100 milligram you can take. If you have symptoms also for a few days, you can take 150 milligram. So these are natural things that you can do to protect yourself, to strengthen your immunity, protect yourself from the virus. So I just want to encourage you. Number one, the joy of the Lord is your strength. You are covered under the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The devil is a liar. The devil is the one who creates fear. God has not given you a spirit of fear. He's given you spirit of love, spirit of power, spirit of sound mind. Amen. So I just bless you. I rebuke that fear. I rebuke that panic. The righteous will never be shaken. Righteous will never be forsaken. We are covered and protected under the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We are not ignorant of the devil's tricks and devices. We are not ignorant of the devil's tricks and devices. No, we are not ignorant, but we have the victory. We walk in the spirit and we walk in the truth and we have the victory. So I bless you. I resist and rebuke every fear. I resist and rebuke anything that wants to weaken your immune system, anything that wants to weaken your spiritual defenses and your natural defenses. I bless you in the name of Jesus. Father, help my brothers and sisters even to come into a better, more natural lifestyle. Just ask forgiveness from the Lord for any negative things you did to your body. Maybe you know that you should not take white sugar. You know the white rice is not healthy, but still you keep taking it. The atta, the white flour, you still keep taking all these things. Maybe you need to ask forgiveness for defiling your temple, even by the foods and by the drinks that you have used, even by the medications. Many times, especially people who are on blood BP lowering medications and what was the other one? Two, three different diabetics also. Different people who take high levels of medicine are at a greater risk. So you just ask the Holy Spirit to help you to come out of any unnatural thing and to come into a holy, healthy lifestyle so that you can drop all these things. But I have 100% confidence none of our people will be touched. None of our people will be touched. But you know, there's one requirement. Yesterday I was thinking about Elijah. I asked our people, you think Elijah starved? When the famine came, did Elijah starve? You know, it depends upon Elijah. Because when the brook dried out, God told Elijah, I have already prepared a widow, but you have to go over there. So, as fast as Elijah obeyed, that's how fast his deliverance could come. As fast as Elijah took the word of the prophet serious and acted upon the word of the prophet, as fast as he did this, he was free and the food was provided, everything was provided for him. Amen. So you can live in total protection, in total liberty, in total freedom. Go to our webpage, check all the articles I have written. There are many, many references. You're at home now. Check your internet, click on every link, get the newsletter online, click on every link, things of how you can do gardening at home, in the buckets, how you can grow food. So many things are there. So many counsels, how you stay healthy even in a lockdown. So many things are there, how you protect your body. Pray that we come into living according to the will of God, plan of God, natural life. Bless you, you will be healthy, you and your family, you will be the ark of God, and you will take many to live a healthy lifestyle together with you. You will feed the nations, that you will be totally different than the people around you. You will give strength, you will give comfort, you will give health and healing to everybody around you. We bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.